My name is Alex Novak, and I'm the product manager for tire test systems here at MTS. The amount of energy lost by a rolling tire directly impacts crucial automotive efficiency measures, such as fuel efficiency and electric vehicle range. Major manufacturers trust MTS rolling resistance systems to meet their standard ISO and SAE testing requirements. Our systems have the capability of testing specimens ranging from motorcycle tires to heavy truck and bus tires. By utilizing tests such as steady state, coast down, and custom time history, they can obtain the information needed to optimize tire efficiency. Behind me is our most capable, industry-leading rolling resistance machine. It consists of a center roadwheel drum that is powered by an electric motor mounted in an ultra-stiff frame with tire test carriages on either side. One side is for large truck and bus tires, with the other being used for smaller passenger car tires. This testing system has the capability to measure rolling resistance in two ways, either through a force measurement taken at the test specimen or by measuring the torque on the central drum. Let's take a closer look at this system. This is the truck and bus side of the rolling resistance machine. Rolling resistance is a measure of the energy lost by a rolling tire. We measure this by mounting a tire onto this spindle and then applying a radial force up to 60 kilonewtons by linear servo hydraulic actuators with temposonic position monitoring. The spindle design is unique and contains no contacting seals, reducing the amount of friction introduced into the measurement from the system. Let's walk around and take a look at what's behind this machine. First of all, you can see the AC motor that drives the central drum. In between the AC motor and the central drum is a rotating torque cell that allows rolling resistance to be measured by the torque of the drum. In addition to the torque cell, the 2 degree of freedom load cell is located here. This load cell measures the tire radial load and the force that resists vehicle motion. System electronics are rail mounted to allow ease of access and reduce excess cabling, and a system status light indicates current status. Let's move to the passenger car side of the system. This is the side of the system for testing passenger car and light truck tires. This side can also perform rolling resistance measurements like the truck and bus side, but has additional functionality. As you can see, there are actuators to apply a radial force of up to 15 kilonewtons, but there are additional motion capabilities. This actuator moves the carriage around the central drum to introduce a slip angle from -2 to 2 degrees, and an actuator in the back introduces a camber angle from -6 to 2 degrees through these hinge points here. These camber and slip servo hydraulics are used to model a vehicle suspension setup in addition to standard rolling resistance measurements. Let's walk around behind and see the backside of this machine. Behind the passenger side of the system, you can clearly see the camber actuator. Additionally, there is another 2 degree of freedom load cell on this side of the system to measure the forces on the tire. The entire system of the passenger car side, the central drum, and the truck and bus side is built on an ultra-stiff frame to reduce deflection during measurement. The system is precisely laser-aligned and calibrated at a system level, ensuring the most accurate measurements. The rolling resistance system operates using an industry-proven MTS controller and tire software. This powerful combination of hardware and software enables testing to several ISO and SAE standards using preloaded rolling resistance tests and report templates. Additional tests can be easily added by the user. For a steady state test, the tire is ramped to a specific set of operating conditions and held at these conditions for a defined time interval to stabilize the tire. At the end of the time interval, rolling resistance data is collected. Examples of this type of test would be ISO 28580 and SAE J1269. For a coast down test, the tire is ramped to a specific speed and stabilized for a defined period, then slowed down through several speed steps in the time frame of a vehicle rolling to a stop. Rolling resistance data is taken after each speed with a few seconds to stabilize the test system. An example of this test would be SAE J2452. MTS N-level tests are used to program in a series of test conditions over time to create a time history test. This type of program could be used to create a vehicle driving cycle like the WLTP. The rolling resistance system is a key part of the MTS tire testing portfolio, alongside systems that measure tread wear or force and moment dynamics of the tire. For more information about the rolling resistance tire system or any of our other tire systems, please contact your local MTS sales representative or visit us at mts.com.